So class 9, open up your books on the chapter Reach for the Top. Today we are going to read this chapter. As in the previous lecture, I have given you an introduction about it. Okay, so I hope that you have remembered that this is Reach for the Top is actually containing two excerpts. Okay, one for Santosh Yadav and another for Maria Sharapova. Okay, both were quite hardworking, preserving nature they have. And they were putting in their hard efforts, stern efforts in order to get the achievement. And finally, their achievement is definitely rewarded. Santosh Yadav, she has turned out to win the national award, as she has scaled Mount Everest twice. And she's one of the youngest in her age who has scaled Mount Everest, right? And Maria Sharapova, I don't think so an introduction is required. She's one of the famous tennis player. And being reaching to the top, it is not, you can say, a steady journey. So many ups and downs, so many rises and falls are included in it. To reach to the top is another thing. But to maintain the position at the top is a great thing, which is very, very difficult. People go to top. Okay, you must have seen many people rising to name and fame these days. But how many of them are maintaining it? That is very, very difficult. Okay, because some people, they think that now we have achieved what we have thought and now this is end to our struggle. No, struggle never stops through life and learning never stops through life. One always learn, one always, you can say, keep on going. One on always keep on learning throughout the life. And it is just because of this that one is able to maintain its position. So through these chapters, what the writer wants to deliver to us is that you should, when you read any chapter, you will be imbibed with moral values. Some moral values that will be a part of your life. And try to imbibe them in your life. Okay? In your character and in your personality. So coming up to Santosh Yadav, who was a girl from Haryanvi background, and her achievement was climbing Mount Everest twice. So see the book. Think for a while and make a list of 3 to 5 persons you idolize or admire very much for their achievements. Your idols may be from any sphere of life, sports, medicine, media, or art and culture. So let us make a list whom you idolize. Have you ever thought that I would like to become like this? Have you ever idolized? Parents, okay, right, very good. Because I think parents are the first, they are providing first-hand experience to each and every child. Okay, they are delivering, because whatever you are learning, whatever you are, it is just because of parents. Okay. And after that, school. Both these places, house and school, home and school, they are playing a great and major role in the development of the character as well as personality of a child. Your thinking, your way of speaking, how you move, how you speak, how you work, how you represent yourself. It is just because of these two things. Moreover, the home environment, homely environment, it is very, very important. It is completely affecting, because since the day you have opened up your eyes, since the day you were a child and you have started perceiving the things, you are learning what your elders are doing. Okay? So try to get good values from them. Or after that, after parents, it can be anyone, it can be a star from sports, it can be from the, you can say, acting field, anyone. Have you ever thought? Huh? Who? Neha Dubey. Who is she? Sneha Dubey. She's an ambassador. Ambassador for? UNO ambassador from India? Okay. So what means, why you are idolizing her?
She's really confident. I just really like her confidence, the way of speaking, and all the work that she do for the welfare. I really admire.
You watch her interviews?
Yes.
Okay. So how you get a chance to watch her? Okay, right. She's saying, I would like to be like Sneha Dubey, the UNO ambassador. So it means that when you have an image in your mind, okay, then you try to idolize, like she's saying. When we try to idolize, it means that we are getting those characteristics in our personality. Okay, we are trying to imbibe those values. And somehow, I think the person is successful also. Okay, because life is too short to learn from one's own experiences. Okay, it is very, you can say, it is very much effective as well as favorable for a person to learn from the experiences of other persons. Because what life is actually? It is learning. Our learning is synonym to that of life. We are learning many things in our life. Okay, so when you learn from your own experiences, it will definitely take time. But when someone is sharing the experience, try to relive that. Try to feel, yes, what the other person is saying and whether what the other person is saying is absolutely correct or not. Okay, then it means that you are learning the experiences of other persons. Now, from this complete class, we have just got two names. Just any other? Dr. Kiran Bedi. Okay, she is one and only of a kind. Okay, she has really proved her mettle in every field. Okay, I don't think so an introduction is required to her. And see, among all to shine is how difficult it is. Very, very difficult. Then, Barack Obama and Michelle Obama. Okay, so why? Leadership qualities, yes, there is no doubt. Okay, yes, okay, there is no doubt. IAS officers, you must have seen. I think that YouTube is completely filled up with these toppers. And how much hard work they are putting in, we can't even imagine. Okay, you must have heard that one of the child of her school, he has first of all cleared PCS and now UPSC exam. It means if he is from our school, he can, everybody can. Thing is that you need to put in your hard efforts. And nothing is impossible to achieve. Right? Okay. So finally, it means, but I am happy to listen that nobody has spoken about the stars. Okay, because at this age, at teenage, people are usually, you can say, they are fans of many, you can say, heroes in the movies, okay, or in this star life, okay. But actually, what we fantasize is only their real life, not real life. And real life and real life is quite opposite to each other. What they display on the screen is reality? No. What characters they are displaying is reality? No. But how that person is doing well in his life, that is actually the thing. Okay? But I think so that all these stardom icons, they are in one or the other controversy after one or the other day. So I don't think so. They are quite good enough to be a good example for our youngsters. We like them. Yes, of course. We like them because, you know, that these advertisements which are made, they are so, you can say, creatively planned to get hold of your brain. Ek ad aa jaye TV pe na, kisi bhi cheez ki, to we are mad after buying that product without looking and without overlooking its consequences. Okay? So it means that they are so creative, okay, that they know how to tame the mind of other persons. This is what marketing is. Right? This is, you have absolutely said very well that we can like them because what they are showing and we are watching. But what they are not showing, we are not watching. But we can't idolize them. Okay? Coming back. Your teacher will then discuss your choices with you to find out the top five idols of your class. This we have done. So next. The only women in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son, was regarded as a blessing, and a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. So this is what the story is about. Santosh Yadav, she is born in a family where the birth of a son is considered to be auspicious. It is always welcome. But that of a girl, it, of course, it is not seen as a curse, but it is not so welcome. Okay? So sometimes, somewhere, this thinking still prevails in our society. Okay? That a son is required. Why? Because this is just a setup that has been made by our society. Okay? Being a girl, being a boy, in your family, every family has its own thinking. I'm not saying that what they are thinking is wrong. Okay? Every person is free to think on his own. Okay? So you must have seen that whenever there is a birth of a boy in the family, there is much elation, much happiness. Okay? No doubt, if a girl is born, no doubt they are thinking that we are cursed. But that happiness is not comparable to that when boy is born. Okay? Why? Where its roots are. It's a very deep question. Its roots are back into our society. So God has made two beings, one male and one female. And I think what I feel is that when male and females were born, so I think that in order to divide the work, male has taken over the job of the outside work, going out to bring food for the family, and female has to take care of the family. But slowly and gradually, what has happened that there develops a breach, there develops a gap between the roles of both these, that one cannot take the role of other. But in the starting, it must not be like that. Aise nahi hua hoga. We people have developed that role. And ultimately, when we say one thing again and again, that turns out to be, you can say, that turns out to be a reality for the society. Okay? Aisa hoga ki women jo hai wo sirf ghar ki char diwari mein hi achhi rakhti. They should be in the four-cornered house only, four-cornered wall only. Right? And it is only in the 20th and 21st century that they have come out. And now the time has come when women are more successful than men. If you see women in any profession, be it a company, wherever they are always hardworking. Many articles are being published on the role of and the sincerity of women, that wherever they are always hardworking. Men always take the things, let it go. They always have this attitude. They always take the work as burden. They have a relaxing attitude. But wherever a woman is there, she's more responsible. Because responsibility is, you can say, inbuilt in her character. Because if she is not going to be responsible for her house, how would she be able to take care of her children? It will be completely a mess. Just imagine a day when your mother doesn't wake up and what kind of mess you face. Right? So roots, I was talking about, that its roots are lying back deep in the previous times when men and women, they have been given birth by God. And ultimately, it is we human beings who have made this. Ultimately, it was only the division of work. Agar aisa hua hota, may it be a, you can say, reversible fact that, for example, that the man would have taken the role of household work, and if women would be, then the reality would be different. So when some things, some points, when they are emphasized again and again, they turn out to be reality of the society. And it is just because of this. And I think that now the time has reached when there is not even a difference between a boy and a girl. What I feel is girls are more successful. If we see the many families, if you look at number of families, so what is the generalization overall is made that wherever girls are there, they are more successful, they are hardworking than boys. Yes, of course. It is male dominant society. Women has to work hard also in order to prove themselves. Okay? So many examples are there, we have seen. Okay, in our country, all over the world, We have seen a number of examples of it. So whatever it is only whatever the gaps, whatever the, you can say, negative feelings, it is only in our thinking. And a society, it is also influencing a lot. Okay, suppose if a family is quite happy with a girl child, लेकिन दो चार अगर आकर उसको इधर उधर से कह देंगे ना relatives या कोई, sometimes somewhere that point pricks, okay, it tickles the mind. It means that one should be strong and firm. हमने when we have read that chapter Santosh, that is Evelyn, we know, we have read that if you are going to a right place, you will definitely get there. Okay, so it means that if you know that you are right, then ultimately what will happen? Nobody will change your thinking. Thing is that you should have complete trust in yourself. That is more important. Okay, ab dekho, for example, you are sitting in exams. How many of you have complete trust in yourself? Complete trust. मैं बताती हूँ पेपर में पता क्या होता है. अब एमसीक्यू आया, मान लो वन इज डूइंग एमसीक्यू, उसकी नजर चलेगी दूसरी शीट पे, या इफ समबडी विल टेल नहीं इसका ये आंसर है, तो आपको अपने ऊपर ज्यादा डाउट होता है मैंने रॉन्ग किया, आपको लगता है वो उसका ठीक है. ऐसे ही होता है ना, ऐसे ही होता है. ओके, आपको लगता है नहीं उसने ये कहा, हाँ ये होगा लेकिन ये नहीं होगा जो मैंने ठीक किया, वेदर इट इज राइट. ओके, सो दिस इज मीन्स टू हैव ट्रस्ट इन योर सेल्फ. Okay, if you are doing anything, trust yourself. Yes, if I am doing this, I'm right. Okay, I'm right in doing this. Okay, to have trust in yourself is again a great thing. One should be trustworthy to oneself. Okay, if you are not trustable to yourself, you are not to anybody. Okay. Have trust, whatever you are doing, think that yes, if I'm doing it is for a reason, justify your reason, then do it. Without thinking if you are doing anything, that will ultimately lead to destructive results. Okay, so coming back to the chapter, when her mother was expecting Santosh, a traveling holy man giving her his blessing assumed that she wanted a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. Now, so what happened when her mother was expecting? You know, whenever you see any sadhu, sant, mahatma, saint or seer nearby you, they would always bless a woman, ki bhagwan tumhe beta de. Right, in the same manner, he was expecting that this lady would also ask for a baby boy. But her grandmother, Santosh grandmother, she was standing by the side. She asked for the blessing of a girl. And that sadhu, that holy man, he was surprised. Why? Because the holy man was also surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessing. And as destiny would have it, the blessing seemed to work. So because nobody has ever asked for a blessing for a girl, everyone was asking for a boy, and definitely his blessing worked. Santosh was born the sixth child in a family with five sons, a sister to five brothers. So why her birth was welcomed in the family? It is because of the reason that she was a, there were five boys in the family and she is sixth child is a girl. And everyone was so happy that they are blessed with the girl. She was born in the small village of Jonivas of Rewari district in Haryana. Underline it where she was born. Okay. And write down the question here. Why her birth was welcomed in the family? Why her birth was welcomed in the family? So, the girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment, because the parents were feeling contentment after the birth of a girl child. They felt very happy. So, this is the reason why she was named as Santosh, which means contentment. Okay, write down the question. Why Santosh was given the so-called name? Why Santosh was given the so-called name? Santosh was given the so-called name. But Santosh was not always content. Now, but Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. But she is see the irony in her name. Irony means what actually is different from actually what is happening. Her name was Santosh, but she is always dissatisfied with the traditional way of life. She is never happy with that way of life. Why? She began living life on her own terms from the start. So since the time she started, she's just living her life on her own terms. Whatever she wanted, she wanted to do it in her own way. And where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. Looking back, she says now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and a rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. Underline this. So what she has said, she said that this is very great point made by her. That if I chose a correct and rational path, see, correct, rational means with reason. She's justifying that if I'm doing this, why I'm doing this. She said that if I chose a rational and correct path, the others around me had to change, not me. It means that she is trustable more in himself. She had complete trust that yes, if I'm doing, she's not going to change if others are doing. And on that day, I talked about rebel. Okay. So it means that she's a sort of rebel. She's not conforming to the ways of society that are prevalent. Okay. And it is because of these rebels, there are changes in the society. Okay. And this is the reason why she said that the other people around me, they would change, but not me. I would not change. So Santosh's parents were affluent. So write down the question there. How Santosh was different from the other girls of the village? How Santosh was different from other girls of the village? Santosh's parents were affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools, even to the country's capital, New Delhi, which was quite close by. So Santosh's parents, they were quite affluent, rich, okay, able to afford all the expenses to send their children to the city school and even to New Delhi also. But it was the tradition of the family that all the children, they are studying in the village school. So she also has to study in the village school. School, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way. See, she was fighting the system in her own quiet way. She is not rebelling. She's not creating chaos in the family at that time. But when the right moment arrived, she started speaking when the right moment arrived. When it was, and the right moment was, it came when she turned 16. At 16, most of the girls in her village, they used to get married. And Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. So it was the time when she has turned out to be 16, because it is at that time when the girls, they had to get married. But she said, no, I won't. I would not conform to these rules of the society. I would not get married. Rather, what she wanted to live her way on her own. She wanted to study further. And this is the first, you can say, thing that she put forward at the age of 16. As 16 was the age when the girls, they used to get married. So let us see how her progress to a complete independent woman has come out. Okay, so that's all for today. And in the next class, we will continue further with the same chapter.